Hello and welcome to Proxmox Tutorials. I am William and I will present this video to you. Proxmox VE 4.4 is ready, and I'm excited to show you the new features we've implemented into this version. This release introduces a new dashboard showing the status of your cluster resources at a glance. This includes the overall status of the nodes, a summary about virtual machines and containers. Also, you get a rough overview about CPU, memory, and storage usage, and the list of your nodes. If you have installed Ceph, you can also see the Ceph health status. With a click on the icon, you'll be redirected to the Ceph dashboard. The status includes information about the Ceph monitors, the OSDs, and the placement groups. The performance shows the current usage of the Ceph cluster. We have improved the tools for the Ceph server management on several places. For example, you can set and unset the no-out flag to your Ceph cluster. This is important for maintenance tasks. With Proxmox VE 4.4, creating unprivileged containers is now exposed to the GUI. The Help button brings you directly to the reference documentation. The docu explains the differences between privileged and unprivileged containers. Limiting CPU cores for containers is now available with version 4.4. You can migrate running containers with the new restart mode. If you're using shared or distributed storage, downtime will be a few seconds only. Based on the feedback from our users, we improved our high availability stack. Please note, before you start using Proxmox VE High Availability, make sure that you have at least 3 nodes in your cluster. Also, we recommend that you read the documentation. Simply press the Help button to get there. Proxmox VE 4.4 is available in all of our repositories. Just download the ISO. We are looking forward to your feedback. Simply post on our forum or our mailing lists. I hope the video could reveal some new insights, and you'll enjoy working with Proxmox VE 4.4. Thanks for watching.